The Kennedy class 4 arch is defined as a single, bilateral edentulous area, crossing the midline and located anterior to the remaining teeth. No modification areas exist. The class 4 partial denture often involves replacement of all the incisors in either the maxillary or mandibular arch. In both instances, fixed partial dentures are more desirable when indicated. Contraindications to a fixed partial denture may include length of span, tissue loss, arch contour, and economics. A quadrant support type design is indicated in the class 4 situation. Guiding planes. Proximal guiding planes are usually long, but extensive reduction of proximal surfaces of anterior abutments may compromise aesthetics in some instances. Posterior guide planes are prepared lingually on the abutment teeth and incorporate reciprocating arms. Support. Anterior rests are usually located adjacent to the edentulous space, if the cuspids are present. If the cuspids are not present, one should consider the restoration as a tooth tissue supported partial denture. Posteriorly, rests are usually placed on molar teeth. If using the terminal abutment, a distal occlusal rest is used. Adjacent or double occlusal rests are used if utilizing an embrasure clasp assembly on adjacent abutment teeth. Major connectors. The mandibular major connector will usually consist of a lingual bar or linguoplate, although a labial bar may be used in certain instances. The maxillary major connector may be an anterior-posterior palatal strap, commonly used in the presence of a maxillary torus. The modified palatal plate may be selected, or, in cases of low gagging threshold, the U-shaped major connector may be used. Indirect retention. The tooth-supported RPD does not have a fulcrum line, providing that the posterior abutments are rested and clasped. Indirect retention is usually not required. The tooth tissue-supported RPD, anterior extension base, may have a fulcrum line. Indirect retention is provided by a posterior abutment. When planning anterior tooth retention, recall that clasps may be unaesthetic. If possible, and aesthetics permit, the eye bar is used with 0.01 undercut at the mid-buccal height of contour or distal to it. Embrasure clasps are unaesthetic, particularly in the anterior region. Posterior retention may be provided by a cast circumferential clasp from the distooclusal rest to a 0.01 undercut on the mesia buccal retentive area on the most posterior tooth. Additionally, one may choose an embrasure clasp through an occlusal embrasure area using double occlusal rests, with retentive clasps directed mesially, distally, or both. Reciprocation. Anteriorly, reciprocation may be provided by a lingual plate and proximal guide plate. Other options include a proximal guide plate and either a cingulum rest, or distolingual ball type rest. Posterior reciprocation may consist of cast clasp arms on the lingual, opposite the retentive clasps, or a lingual plate. The denture base may consist of a ladder or mesh. The selection is based on the length of span, anticipation of reline, extensive soft tissue defects, and arch contour. A metal base is normally used with firm healthy edentulous tissue, in areas of inadequate space to insert replacement teeth, or areas where relining is not anticipated. The class 4 RPD is considered by some authors to be an all-tooth supported prosthesis. However, In some instances, a class 4 RPD may derive support from both the teeth and the anterior edentulous ridge, in which case it should be considered an anterior extension edentulous area. Several potential problems exist concerning class 4 removable partial dentures. One such problem is that placement of sufficient guiding planes to ensure a predictable path of placement could become an aesthetic problem. Over-contouring of the proximal surface of a primary abutment tooth would result in an unsightly appearance. Conversely, avoidance of guiding plane surfaces could result in a void or dark triangular area between the placement denture and the natural abutment tooth. The anterior primary abutment is usually a canine or incisor. The sloping lingual surfaces of anterior teeth render it difficult to place an adequate rest to direct forces to the long axis of the tooth. The maxillary cuspid cingulum, however, may provide for placement of a cingulum rest. In the maxillary arch, adequate clearance for a rest may be difficult to attain due to the opposing mandibular occlusion. A ball-type rest may then be used. Posterior rest placement should be as far posteriorly as possible to gain support for the major connector, to completion of the quadrant support, for rigidity, to provide for adequate clasping systems to available retentive areas, and to function as indirect retainers. The distal occlusal rest on the most posterior remaining tooth is often used. In some instances, the use of double occlusal rests with embrasure clasps is necessary to gain access to acceptable available retentive areas. An important transition zone in placement of rests and clasps on the anterior abutment teeth may occur. Once the cuspid is lost and a posterior tooth is the anterior abutment, such as a premolar, we must think in terms of an anterior extension partial denture. The ideal location for the rest will then be the distal occlusal surface of the abutment tooth. This will enable a class 2 lever system rather than a class 1 lever system to apply to the anterior extension area. Similarly, in considering a clasping philosophy concerning the anterior abutment. In a class 4 RPD, we would then utilize the ibotomid buckle, or slightly distal. If the retention is distal, a wrought wire clasp to the distobuccal may be used. If a retentive area is available on the mesial, a mod T clasp to 0.01 mesiobuccal retentive area may be used. The following questions test your grasp of the material presented. Thank you.